Jane is excited that she is turning 50. After all, with age comes a lot of benefits. Fewer responsibilities, more freedom, and a greater sense of emotional strength and wisdom. Unfortunately, also with age comes some new challenges. At her annual checkup, Jane's doctor tells her that she's now at an increased risk of osteoporosis, or weakened bones. With osteoporosis, new bone creation doesn't keep up with old bone removal, leaving people with a greater risk of fractures. Driving home, Jane is a little surprised. She thought osteoporosis was something that old people got. Last year, Jane's dad fell and broke his hip, and the doctor said it was because he has osteoporosis. He's been in a wheelchair ever since. Jane wants to make sure that she doesn't suffer the same fate, so she visits hormone.org to learn more about osteoporosis. One thing she learns is that a visit to an endocrinologist can help identify her level of risk and show her how she can keep her bones strong. That's because osteoporosis is more common in people who have too much or too little of certain hormones in their bodies. At the endocrinologist's visit, Jane discovers that more than 54 million people have osteoporosis or low bone density. And although the risks are greater to those over the age of 40, people of any age can get it. Symptoms could include loss of height, stooped posture, or a bone fracture that occurs from doing something normal like lifting or carrying. Jane has a greater level of risk because she's female, went through menopause early, has a small body frame, and because her dad broke his hip. So she decides to get bone density testing. That's a painless x-ray test that shows how strong her bones are. She learns that while her risk isn't all that high now, with some lifestyle changes, she can do a lot to prevent getting osteoporosis in the future. Those things include diet and exercise changes. Doing so will help Jane stay healthy so she can reap the benefits of growing older without as many challenges. To learn more about osteoporosis and what you can do to prevent it, visit www.hormone.org.